Well, many of us believe that women do better than men in the health stakes. But think again, women are not doing so well when it comes to a very serious health topic, and that is heart attacks. Let's welcome to Studio 10 Kerry Doyle from the Heart Foundation.
Thank you. Lovely to be here.
Kerry, wrongfully we always think heart attacks and we think of overweight, more mature Australian men, but that's not correct, is it?
It's a very kind way to express it. look, no, it's not true. The fact is that heart disease takes 3 times more female lives than breast cancer does.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. It's after menopause, isn't it?
Look, there is that demographic factor, but if I was to tell you that 6.4% of all deaths in this country from heart disease are women under 54 years of age,
wow,
that puts a slightly different complexion on it.
So I listen to that. I think I'm 45. How do I make sure that I'm either not at risk, or how can I minimise my risk?
So the first thing is to actually be aware that women are at risk, not just men. So that's a much harder ask, really, than it sounds, because stereotypes just pervade every aspect of our society, not just for ourselves, but also, you know, in the medical fraternity. So my first message is be aware that heart disease does potentially affect you.
Mm-hmm. But I think it's that whole thing about the different symptoms, like men usually just experience the crushing pain, whereas women might feel nauseous and break out in a cold sweat and, you know...
Yeah, what are the symptoms?
That's a little bit
scary. So you're absolutely right, but only 36% of women actually even see heart disease in the first instance as affecting them. And then an even lower proportion, about 26%, understand.
I'm panicky now. What do we need to look for?
So the first thing you need to do is go to your GP and have a heart health check.
Okay.
Have a good discussion with your GP. Talk about your family history and then talk about your lifestyle risk factors. As we always say, there's not much you can do about your family, but there's a lot you can do about a range of modifiable risk factors. So first thing is to understand whether you're somebody at risk. And just because you might be, you know, a slim, active, healthy eating female doesn't necessarily fully protect you.
What does the pain feel like for a woman? Where does a woman get the pain?
So a woman might not experience any pain.
So a woman could have a heart attack and actually not know that she's having a heart attack.
Correct.
So let's have a look at the warning signs. We've got a graphic here. Take us through this.
So as it shows you, women might, if they do experience pain, jaw pain, neck pain, shoulder pain, back pain and arm pain, much more diffuse and could be across those signs. Nausea, dizziness, breathlessness, and nearly all of the women who have spoken with me have said the thing that made the difference for them, that made them realise that they had to do something, was an overwhelming feeling that something was wrong. Now, that's a pretty diffuse, symptom, really. But if you combine it with the other symptoms, then, you know, you really need to take action.
And reflux.
Absolutely. You know, the number of fabulous women that I've spoken to who've presented their doctors and been sent home with, you know, something for their reflux is quite disturbing because they don't fit the paradigm.
So what then should we do if we're worried that we're having a heart attack?
Ring 000. Nobody ever died of embarrassment, but a lot of people die of heart attacks.
My aunt had a stroke when she was about 70-something, and everyone just put it down to prawn poisoning. She was having prawns at the time, and she did feel nauseous and all those things. The doctor was called, and he said, yes, it was prawn poisoning. It's just that her heartbeat remained erratic, and my cousin took it the next day and decided something was wrong and got him back again, and that's when it was established. So even when you suffer these things, it's not necessarily picked up, is it?
No, you have to be persistent in all health matters, but in particular in this health matter, you need to know your own body, you need to trust your own instincts, and you need to take that kind of action.
And get a second opinion if you're not happy.
Absolutely.
Now, quickly, if people want to just go to the website, is there more information they can get, Heart Foundation?
A lot more information on our website, www.heartfoundation.org/women.
Such an important message. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Really appreciate it. Thank you, Kerry.